अस्सलाम वालेकुम, मेरा नाम है गज़नफ़र अली जावा। मैं बेसिकली बाय एजुकेशन आई एम अ फार्मासिस्ट। आई हैव डन माय मास्टर्स इन एमफिल इन फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री। आई एम परसुइंग माय पीएचडी इन फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री एज वेल। साइड बाय साइड विद द फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री पीएचडी, आई हैव डन माय एमबीए इन फ्रॉम यूएमटी, दैट वाज अ ग्लोबल मैनेजमेंट। And I'm also doing a law degree pursue, which is in third year. Currently, I'm the CEO of Wilshire Labs Private Limited, which is a pharmaceutical manufacturing concern. Well, journey to success, it's a long journey. The most important thing is never give up. There are pitfalls. There are things that might not go the right way as you have predicted. But there is a saying of Hazrat Ali, ke maine khuda ko apne iradon ke tootne se pehchana. So what is important is that you should believe that whatever is happening for the best of your development. Aap dekhein, आप अपना बेस्ट परफॉर्म करें और रिजल्ट्स जो हैं वो आपके कंट्रोल में नहीं होते हैं। यू शुड स्ट्राइव फॉर द बेस्ट एंड लीव द रेस्ट। आई एम इंस्पायर्ड बाय अ लॉट ऑफ लीडर्स ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री, स्पेशली आई वुड लाइक टू मेंशन सैयद बाबर अली। एंड वंस आई हैड द अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ आस्किंग हिम ए डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन दैट इफ यू आर ए डिसीजन मेकर and have you ever regretted a wrong decision? He said that the successful people in career make 6 good decisions out of 10. So by far 4 decisions are wrong, and those people are called successful people. So why regret 4 wrong decisions? So this is something that's part of your duty. Another person I get inspired a lot. I asked him, then we were involved in 2005 catastrophe of the earthquake, that what if we do this and there is something wrong happening. He said only those people do mistakes who do something. So the most important thing is to do something and keep on doing something. So journey to success is not just one thing that you can do. It's a lifelong thing. And for us, it is like in the organization, it's a lifelong learning as well. Motivation is the ultimate thing. People think that motivation could be by your hierarchy in the organization. Motivation could be by how you account people accountable, or how good you are on a subject, and how the people know that your grip on the subject is how strong. But I have a different thought process. I think that the empathy is the most important, and you should be able to walk the talk. The best motivation is inspirational motivation. If you can inspire them and also get inspired, it is not only that you can inspire people, you should also be able to get inspired by the people who have left a mark, left a legacy. So this is the best kind of inspiration, and this not only changes the person but the whole family, because this then is inculcated to their families and to their children. And I've seen huge differences, because I strongly believe that this is a major part of our lives, where we spend maybe 8-9 hours, and then maybe 7-8 hours we sleep. and very less time with our families. Maybe on the weekends we have a lot of time, Saturdays and Sundays. But whatever we learn here, that is what we are going to apply at our married life and family life. So that is what I believe is the best kind of motivation. I set up my own goals. I achieve those goals, break those goals, and set up new goals. It's a continuous process. Whenever a goal is met, so I need a new challenge for myself. But I know I cannot ask or demand this from my peers or my reportees. Even my board does not require this from me. But this is my personality trait. You must be knowing the 7 habits of highly effective people. The 7th habit is sharpening the saw. So that's what I really believe in. That you should be continuously improving on yourself, continuously achieving your goals, continuously improving your SMART goals, and then do the best. My message would be, jump into practical life as soon as possible. I jumped into practical life when I was in 1992 in my 10th grade. Since then, all of my studies are all part-time. So I have been demanding my retirement. They are not giving it to me yet. So the thing is, if you are going to think that I'm going to complete my master's program and then I'm going to come into practical life and then I'm going to maybe join a job or something, this is ridiculous. Because now the world is changing. You have to change with the changing world. I think in future, I see finance, IT and law. These 3 categories are going to merge. And when these 3 merge, the best will be out. Because merging these 3 will never be able to be covered by AI. Yes, one thing will be covered by AI. Maybe IT will be covered. Maybe if you want to do finance, it will be covered by AI. If you want to cover law, it is already covered by IBM Watson. But if you want to combine all of these 3 and then provide the analytics, this is not going to happen. This is the human intellectual mind which can do. So think on those terms and you will be there. Be futuristic, see what the world is doing, what is happening, and do not do what is everybody doing. Go against the tide. Learn. And failure is part of learning.